Hello, my name is Michael Schneiders. I'm the Head of Investor Relations and Sustainability here at Brain Biotech AG in Singenberg, which is just in the proximity of Frankfurt. And I'm very happy to present today on the 11A of 3M numbers, so the first quarter of our fiscal year. And I have to say, we actually had not only good news flow this quarter, but we also were able to present very strong numbers. Before we start with that, just a quick recap, what are we about? The Brain is an industrial biotech company. We focus on breakthrough solutions for bioproducts, nutrition, health, environment, and we do everything from the lab to the production here. I think what's quite important to know is that we have been very successful over the last 28 years. We have a total of around 230 specialty B2B products in the market and about 150 successful industrial partnerships, i.e. giving us a lot of track record to the market. What will be new for the future is that we are not only going to be a partner to the industry, but we also want to be developing our own products, produce them and sell them, and hence press basically a higher share of value in the pocket over the product over the life cycle. If you look at the Brain group, we really have two differentiations, the bioindustrial part, that's where we sell the products, and on the left-hand side, bioscience, that's where we do scientific services, and we have our own incubator, so our own product which we develop to bring to market. I have talked about that in the past quite a bit, so I'll just tell you what the highlights of this quarter were. On the right-hand side, we acquired Breatec, a business being active in baking enzymes, about 7 million of revenues, and you can easily see with 28.2 million revenues we made in the last financial year, adding 7 million by an acquisition is quite large for our size, and obviously will add significantly to growth in our bioindustrial division, giving us here market breadth and scale, which we are looking for. On the left-hand side, also two very successful projects this quarter. First of all, analytical discovery has extended their partnerships on pharma development with Favaris. And I'm going to talk to that in more detail in a second. And also on SolasCure, our spin-out for wound debridement, we were able to have a very successful Series B funding with a pre-money valuation of that rising by 50%. A bit more in detail on Breatec. Breatec is an ingredients and concentrates business for the milling and baking industry. Milling and baking is one of the largest enzyme markets in the world with attractive growth rates. Sales last year around 7 million, EBITDA margin around 7%. And 60% of their product portfolio are enzymes, and the rest is adjacent products for the baking and milling industry. Brain acquired initially 62% of the company for 3.7 million euros, plus certain payouts if EBITDA milestones are reached. We have a call put option in place to acquire the whole of the business over the next couple of years. And with the initial multiples paid around 0.8 times EV sales and about 12 times EV EBITDA, I think we paid quite some attractive multiples. The first year, we're going to face integration M&A costs around 400 to 450,000 euros. But we think that in the next years, we can realize significantly, particularly procurement synergies that's in the rest of the group, so that they are very, very hopeful that we can bring the today's margin of 7% to clearly north of 10% over the next couple of years. We have strong synergies across the group, mainly on procurement. It's a very good strategic fit, and we think we can further grow its business by itself by further bolt-on acquisitions and with organic sales growth. Talking about our pharma successes here, DHA-121, that is basically a cooperation with Favaris listed on the NASDAQ, developing a drug for an orphan disease called hereditary angioedema, a rare disease, but a very life-threatening, lethal disease potentially. And here we're developing a drug compound, DHA-121, put together with our daughter company, Alutikon Discovery in Potsdam. And Favaris has now given us basically a second a research contract that we develop alternative compounds to DHA-121 to further conquer the market. Perfect example how Brain can develop a pharma compound without having basically a clinical team ourselves. It is clearly, I think, a sign of trust that also the second lot of the development goes to Analyticon, our daughter company. And last but not least, we're obviously currently evaluating that we can put additional pharma products in the pipeline. Why pharma? Because in pharma, the margins are very high and we have high royalty potential from these products. Speaking of pharma, SolasCure, a spin-off, which we have done a couple of years ago. Brain itself is really an expert in enzyme development. We are not so much an expert in clinical development. So SolasCure has been founded for the clinical development. And before you can basically treat a chronic wound and heal it, you need to clean it. And that's called wound debridement. And our enzyme, ORACE, focus exactly on that field. We have done our Series B1 financing, raising £3.7 billion. Pre-money valuation has been rising by plus 50%, so very strong here. We think the financing will last until the end of phase 2A. We have chosen an innovative structure in the UK targeting very high net worth investors. 75% existing investors, 25% new. And Brain basically participated around the pro rata stake around and keeps its stake around 41%, investing £1 million of cash. Pre-money valuation keeps rising. Phase 2A is running. We are further recruiting patients now multiple sites, also de-risk the corona component a little bit. And we expect really strong interest from the industry in that product if we successfully close phase 2A, which should be the case somewhere in the course of this year. And then we evaluate all options for SolasCure, including a sale of the combined entity. Another very important milestone which you could report to the market this quarter was our partnership with Formo. Formo Bio is a Berlin-based business, which basically is trying to replace the cow in the milk process. So they're trying to find animal-free milk proteins via precision fermentation. The precision fermentation is a skill which is really very much to the core of Brain. First of all, we can basically program cells, that's needed. We can then express what we have ever programmed in microorganisms, ferment these microorganisms, and then basically clean up these compounds to get only the milk protein out of it, which is needed for further processes. So that in that process, we can basically incorporate all of our skills in Brain, genome engineering, then basically production strains, optimizing these production strains, fermentation processes, and getting that to the final product. What Formo will do with milk protein is basically bring mozzarella and ricotta to the supermarket and then on a completely animal-free basis. And by doing so, they save around 91 to 97% of the greenhouse gas emissions, about 99% almost of the water consumption. And obviously, it's very going to be very good for animal welfare. And there's a perfect example for us, how actually our Brain engineering tusks, so our own CRISPR technology, our genome scissor, can actually be a very powerful tool to have become a unique selling point. We can actually incorporate it in the full potential of the group, also with production hall strains. And by doing so, we can create TMS Plus, i.e. not only tailor-made solution business with fee for services, but we can also create milestone income from that and royalty upside, which is very exciting for us. And of course, we hope that the formal product will be very successful on the market. Talking about Brain engineered CAS, our genome editing technology is very, very important for us and could be transformative to the whole company. But of course, to protect your IP, you need to have the rights to your IP, and hence patents are very important. And what has been for us very, very powerful is that the European Patent Office has given us a written notice claiming essentially that our nucleases are novel and inventive, which means they are patentable under European legislation and global legislation. That is, we don't have a patent yet, but we have a very strong sign from the European Patent Office that the technology is patentable. And hence, we can also start now doing a licensed business on our proprietary Brain engineered CAS technology. Let me talk a bit about the technology and the platform that we are trying to do. If you focus on the middle in the circle, you see new code, and that's exactly what we're trying to do. We will found a new company where we're going to inject all of our employees and of our IP around the Brain engineered CAS and Brain metagenomic CAS, so our both gene scissor tools. That new co is supposed essentially to further develop the R&D, look for further IP creation, do licensing and partnerships, look for new applications, and then basically develop a consumables, hardware business, and consulting business out of that. We basically design the tools. The applications then, so the genome engineering will be done by partners, and we're looking here for strong partners to out-license that. A couple of the partners you can see on the top. We have already a deal in agriculture with a non-disclosed partner. We have a life science application partner with Sartorius for the non-exclusive phases. We do marine applications with SAMS, the Scottish Association of Marine Sciences. And we do producer strain development, which is very important for us going forward, also the University of Leiden in the Netherlands. And the Formo deal we just talked about, that is placed basically in the heart of a bioindustrial business. And Brain AG will continue, even with the spin-off of Inuco, basically to focus on all the technologies around industrial biotechnology, which also involve the CRISPR tools. We call that the CRISPR for use service. We use that as the unique selling point in our tailor-made solutions business. We will do production strain optimization. We also will develop third-party strains. And that's all that create essentially TMS business with milestone and royalty upside. So very positive for us. Let me now jump into the numbers. We had 26% revenue growth in this quarter. 86.6% of this were organic. The delta comes from the bioscience acquisition, which we have basically done in the first quarter of last year. Very, very good growth, organic growth ahead of the bioscience division. And here we had a bit of a dip last year, and that business came full at back swing. And last part of that business also driven right now by our back technology. Also bioindustrial, strong with 20% growth, 11.1% organic, except the delta is the biofund business in the US. The big swing in our adjusted EBITDA, the better sales growth from minus 1.5 million to minus 300,000. And also very strong operating cash flow, which was minus 200,000, so it's minus 2.1 million in the same period of last year. That brings us to still a very comfortable cash position of 22.6 million at the end of the quarter, with 24.9 million at the end of last quarter. So reasonably low capital consumption, despite the fact that we essentially were investing 600,000 euros in the first quarter alone in our CRISPR technology. And of course, we will do so and continue to do so in the rest of the year. We promised at Q4 that Brain, after three stagnant years, will come back to growth. Q4 already was strong. I think Q1 is a very strong sign that that growth is going to continue. And we do actually forecast strong growth also for the rest of the year. So that really, I think, Brain as a growth company is back to its growth profile it had for many years before. Let me quickly also talk about the risks. I think COVID right now is vanishing. We seem to be managing the COVID risks very well, and the business, also particularly bioscience, has been coming back. But of course, there are other risks. And these risks mainly center around supply chain. We could have been grown even much more dynamic in the first quarter than we already have done if we wouldn't have had selected supply chain restraints, particularly on raw materials, input factors, consumables and packaging, but also basically with rising logistics costs or the non-availability of logistics services in the first place, i.e. missing containers, which held back our growth to a certain extent. Having said that, so far we could prove that we could manage these challenges, but of course there might be challenges going forward. It might become even stronger in the current economic situation. Now let me come to our targets. That is a novum for Brain. For the first time since the company has been listed, we really have been now issuing quantitative guidance. And the reason why we could do that is because the management team here in Swingberg has been working very hard to consolidate all the daughter companies, put proper controlling instruments in place, put proper planning instruments in place, and basically align the full group. So we're now very comfortable with our own process, and hence able to issue also quantitative guidance for the year. We're now looking to grow group sales to 43 to 45 million, with significant growth in both divisions, with bioscience growing around 50 to 25%, bioindustrial growing 10 to 15%, and an adjusted EBITDA around break even, excluding the CRISPR investments. CRISPR investments are right now to be planned in the range of 2.5 to 3.5 million, and group capex of 7 to 8 million. This whole guidance does still exclude the recent acquisition of Breatec because it has been closed some weeks ago, but we give you a first indication what Breatec would add. We think around 7.5 million revenues, adjusted EBITDA around 550,000, which basically equates to an EBITDA margin still around 7%. And with the 6M reporting, we will update that guidance, including the Breatec deal. And so we were looking for really strong growth here in this year on top line, organically and inorganically. We are looking to come much closer to our break-even targets on EBITDA, as we have promised before. And with strongly investing into the CRISPR platform, we are basically paving the way now in the future and also the way into the new core, which could be significantly value-enhanced and for Brain. We will report the next numbers on May the 30th with our 6M numbers and hope to be able to report to you again. And of course, if you have any further questions, please drop me an email or give me a shout here in Swingenberg. Great that I could present to you, and please come back with any more questions. Thank you.
Hi there. Since you watched this company video until the end, I'm guessing you liked the video. That's probably because we work very hard to create the most engaging and value-added content possible for you. If you're a stock-listed company or corporation and want to find out how we at C11A can make a company video with and about you, please email us at community@seat11a.com.